Hi, I'm Jasmine Warga, and I'm going to read the first couple of pages from my new book, The Sheep of Thunder. And The Sheep of Thunder is told from two perspectives, Cora Hamad and Quinn McCauley. And the first chapter opens from Cora's perspective. So that's what I'm going to read from. Chapter one. I like learning things, especially about math and science, because they help explain why the world is the way it is. A famous mathematician once said, mathematics is the music of reason. I've always believed that. The best thing about math is that it makes sense. The actual best thing about math is that everything adds up, all neat and in order. Here's what I know about the number 12. 12 is 4 times 3. 12 is 6 times 2. 12 is 10 plus 2. That is all simple math, right? Elementary school stuff. Reason and logic. 12 is also 2 less than 14. 14 is how old Mabel was when she died. I'm 12 today. Someday in the future, I will be more than 12 plus 2. I will become older than my older sister. There is no music in that fact. There is absolutely no reason. It does not add up, all neat and in order. You ready, Corey? Dad asks as he slips on his navy windbreaker. Grams is standing beside him in her puffy red coat. It's not even that cold outside, and she's been wearing it for 10 minutes already. Grams is always ready before everyone else. We really don't have to go. Of course we do. Dad gives me a smile, and I know it's supposed to look encouraging, but I can see the sadness leaking out behind it. Don't be silly, Grams says, draping an arm around my shoulder and pulling me close enough to her that I can smell her hair that always smells like lemons. Grams is the only person I know who washes their hair with a bar of soap instead of shampoo. We always go to Pete's. This is true. Going to Pete's for birthdays has been a Hamad family tradition for as long as I can remember. We go, all four of us, Grams, Dad, Mabel, and me. We sit in the same back corner booth, the one with the saggy cushions, and order chocolate milkshakes and an extra large pizza. Whosever birthday it is gets to pick the pizza toppings. For Mabel's, we'd always get barbecue chicken. Dad usually picks veggie, though I think he only does that because he's always trying to get everyone to eat more vegetables. When Mabel and I were younger, he printed off a copy of a nutrition guide, circled the vegetable and fruit section, and hung it up on our wall. Mabel let it stay for a day before ripping it down and replacing it with a picture of a rainbow she'd drawn at school. Grams usually chooses whatever the monthly special is, and me, I pick cheese. Mabel used to say that cheese was boring, and while the truth is, I'm a little bit boring. Boring is okay with me. Boring is safe. Boring is your sister coming home from school like you expect her to.
Thank you for that. Oof. Okay.